Hello students, today we will start HTML 5. We have been through the introduction to basic terminologies related to creation of web page. HTML is an evolving language with different versions supporting different features. HTML 5 is currently used because it supports mobile technology. The major browsers are Google Chrome, Mozilla, Microsoft Edge, Safari, Opera and Apple, which supports the feature of HTML5. In 11th standard, we have studied different controls related to forms: link, test, radio, checkbox, submit button, reset button, select, option and text area. These controls are used to collect different kinds of user inputs such as contact details like name, address, single or multiple options from group of options, as well as clearing and submitting data. Now HTML5 has introduced additional form control which can be used for validation purpose. So let us start HTML5. So HTML5 advanced input elements are: input type equal to color defines a color picker. Input type equal to number defines a field for entering a number. Input type equal to URL defines a field for entering URL. Input type equal to image define an image as a submit button. Input type equal to email defines a field for an email address. And input type equal to date defines a date picker for year, month and day. So let us see all this advanced control which is used in HTML5. So let us type one by one in notepad and see. Doctype HTML says that my document is of HTML. HTML head, then title, head finish, and in body, form, in form. Suppose my first control, input type equal to color, name equal to N1. And now open with browser. So this is my color picker. You can select color from this color picker. Now next control. Let us copy this. Input type equal to, suppose we will use number. And name equal to N2. Save this and refresh this. This is filled for entering number. You can select number from here. Then third one, input type equal to image. You can define image as a submit button. Name equal to N3. Save this and refresh this. This is my submit button. You can submit your form detail when you click on the submit button. Then next control. Let us remove this. We can write here button. So again we will save this and see this effect. Yes. Then next control, date control. So to insert date control in a form, we have to write input type equal to date. So date picker will be shown. Name equal to N4. Save this and refresh this. So this is date picker. You can pick date from this date picker like this. You can change your month as well as year also. Next control, input type equal to email. For example, to enter email, in this email field. It validates your email while you submit the form details. So this is your email control. Here you enter email address, and suppose if you type any wrong email address and you click on submit, then it will validate. Please include @ in the email address. So if you include @, it also again, when you click on this validate key, it should also contain dot part. So now you submit this, then this will be okay. So this control also validates your email address. Email must contain @ and dot sign. Next control, input type equal to month. So you can select month and year. Name equal to N6. Save this and refresh this. So this is February 2020. So this shows month and year. Now next control, input type equal to date type local. So it will show both date and time. Name equal to N7. Save this. This control defines both date and time. So here you can select date. From here you can select hours and minutes. So this is date time control. Next, input type equal to time. So you can select only time. This control defines time. Name equal to save this and refresh. So here you can select time. This is in hours and this is in minutes. Now next control, week. So it defines week and year. Change name, for example N9. Now save this and refresh this. So this is week and year. So when you select, suppose in January 14 will be the week 3. Now next, input type equal to file. You can select file. You can upload file. Change name of this control, save this and refresh this. So choose file from here, it will open this. You can choose any one file which you want to open. So like this you can open this. Yeah, if you want to choose more than one file, then you can write here multiple also. At a time you can select more than one file. Then input type equal to tell, it is used to define input field that used to contain telephone number. So telephone number type equal to tell. So in this you can enter telephone number. So these are controls with validation. Automatically validates your input while you submit the value. Here you can pick number. Here you can select date. Here you can write any email address, select month and year. Year date and time, both will be selected. Year time in hours and seconds. Here you can select week of a year. Suppose this is 18th week. If I select April 27, then it will be 18th week of 2020. From the year, you can select file and you can open this file. So this is file, and here you can enter telephone number. So these are advanced control used for accept input from user as well as it also validate your input. So input type equal to range defines a range control. Default range is from 0 to 100. Date time local defines a date picker that includes year, month, day and time. Time, week. Then input type equal to search defines a text field for entering a search string like a site search or Google search. So we have seen all these controls. These are some input restriction which we can use for validation purpose. So you can use all these attributes with input tag. So suppose if you use disabled attribute with input tag, then it specifies that an input field should be disabled, means you cannot enter in disabled field. Then if you use attribute max, specifies the maximum value for an input field. So you can use this max and min with number as well as range. Input type equal to number, yeah, input type equal to range. You can specify this max and min attribute to specify the minimum value and maximum value for input field. Then pattern specifies a regular pattern expression to check the input values. For example, if you input telephone number, then you can specify a pattern for entering telephone number. Then read only specifies that an input field is only read only. You cannot make change within that field. Placeholder, this acts as a temporary label showing the purpose of text field without requiring a label tag. Then required specifies that the input field is required, must be filled out. Autocomplete specifies whether the form or input field should have autocomplete on or off. Autofocus specifies that input field should automatically get focused when page loads. Height and width specifies the height and width of input type equal to image. When you use image as a submit button, at that time you can use this attribute height and width. And multiple specifies that user is allowed to enter more than one value in input element. This works with input types like email and file, means you can select more than one files if you use multiple. So we can use all these attributes with input tag. So let us see. So suppose if I use input type equal to file, and here if I use multiple, I can select multiple file. Save this and open and refresh this. Now when I choose this file, I can select this as well as these two files, and here you can say two files because this is multiple. Then placeholder, suppose in email, if you write placeholder, this is temporary label, office email only. So when you save this and refresh this, you can say office email ID only. This is your temporary label. When you select this email ID, at that time temporary label went off. Now you can specify mean and max range in a number. Suppose mean equal to 10 and max equal to 20. Save this and refresh this. So here if you select this number, minimum is 10 and maximum is 20. You cannot select more than 20, yeah, less than 10. So this is your mean and max range. Then suppose if you write here input type equal to number and mean max and autofocus, so when I refresh, save this and refresh this, my focus is on number. See, my cursor is blinking in number field. So this is autofocus. Then compulsory required field, you can write it as required. Suppose telephone number, if I write here required, and if I do not write anything and press this submit button, then please fill out this field. So this is required field. You must write telephone number here and then you can press submit button. So this is required. This is small example of form. Here we are creating this form. So for this, first you have to write doc type HTML, then HTML body, then form method equal to, you can write post as well as get, action, any URL or file name, any email address where you want to submit your form data, then name, input type equal to text, name equal to MFIL, and autocomplete means this is autocomplete field in which you can type your name, then input type equal to email, name equal to email, EM, here you can enter email address and it will validate your email address when you submit this form detail. Then date picker, you can select date from a date picker, then you can select time from a time picker. So input type equal to time, name equal to TMC, you can select time picker. Number of years, input type equal to number. So mean value is 1 and max value equal to 100. You can select number from 1 to 100. Then phone, input type equal to tell, you can get control in which you can enter telephone number. Name equal to PH, and pattern means you can enter your telephone number in this pattern. You can enter 0 to 9, any digit for two places, and then for hyphen, and then 10 places again in which you can enter 0 to 9. So 2-10, 2 digits from 0 to 9 and 10 digits from 0 to 9. So this is your pattern to enter telephone number, and this field is required field. Since you can not leave this field empty, you have to enter telephone. Input type equal to URL, you can enter URL in this. Then input type equal to image, it defines
image as a submit button. So this is your submit button. When you put your cursor on this button, alternate text for image will be displayed. Click here to submit, and the image flower.png is displayed on this submit button. /form/body.